natural light candid portraits. I don't use studios or lights or props or anything. I just kind of work with what's there. I work mostly with kids, but I work a lot with NGOs. And plus, I love to wander around Asia just taking shots for my own general amusement. And this is kind of, my look is shallow depth of field, so it's kind of blurred out backgrounds. I think it's worth talking about photography. It's worth saying that photography is about seeing. You know, people now want to talk about gear and this and that, and you know, do I need this lens, that lens? No, you need to learn how to see. Once you learn to see, then equipment does make a difference. But so there's three things I think you should look for when you're trying to like make your photography better in terms of natural light. One is just light, obviously. And I think this is the easiest thing to learn. I think it's the thing that people most often get wrong. So you just want to get soft light, and you really want to get light in the eyes. The eyes tell the story most of the time, and you want to get highlights, or what we call catch lights. Also, composition. And I don't think of composition just in terms of like a 2D thing of where the person is in the frame, although that's important. But also thinking what's going out of focus as you go further back into the frame, because things get more out of focus when you're working with a sort of blurred backgrounds, and also the way that the colors kind of relate. And then there's the moment. And I think you can't really plan for this, but once you got the other two things right, and you get the moment, then it really is. I just took this the other day, I was wandering around Battambang for a week, and I was taking this guy's picture, and his cow came up and started licking him. So, you know, if I hadn't been set on the other two things, the shot wouldn't have been as special. Same thing here. Because I like to work with these out-of-focus backdrops, it creates kind of, the viewer has to work a little bit to understand what's going on. You know, your backgrounds become more, let's say, painterly. But you know, the moment is there, you can see its mouth, and you got it. So, briefly, what you have to do is, your aperture and your camera opens up. And you got to get it on the left-hand side there, and get your aperture opened up. So then your camera compensates by giving you a faster shutter speed. Because people, when I do photo coaching, people generally have these numbers reversed. And that is the biggest problem. So you gotta look at your camera, and I like to work with prime lenses like this. I don't like all these zoom lenses and stuff. And this is a 50 millimeter lens, and it's a 1.4. So you have to RTFM, as we say, read the manual. And basically it's generally an A or AV setting, so you can control your aperture. And then once you start opening up your aperture, boom, stuff like this happens where your subject is frozen, it takes care of all that camera shake problem you see all the time, and plus then your backdrops start to go out of focus, and you get this kind of 3D look happening. So that's really, you know, a big part of my kind of shtick is this kind of look. And same thing with this. Again, I got nice light on the kid's face, so what I do is I just open my lens up. I don't care if there's other people in the shot. I just make sure that there's nice light in the eyes, and I focus, just always focus on the eyes. That's the way you gotta nail. And so this has got nice light, it's got, you know, composition, and it's got a moment, but the moment it's kind of happening with the other people. The number one thing you have to do, or that I do all day long when I'm working, is where's the light coming from? And I just see people again. It's kind of counterintuitive, but people are always getting this, turning around, they're always shooting into the nice light. You gotta look behind you, and if there's nice soft light, this one's tricky because the light's coming over her shoulder and coming back. That's some 3D color there. But generally, whoa. And but a little bit with windows. And windows are great because it comes, you can get it behind you, but I like windows coming in from an angle. Again, get the shaded side of the face towards you, make sure there's light in the eyes. This is why I work with Father Joe here, and this is just a slum school here in Yanakot in Bangkok. And I couldn't get a shot in this room, but then there was a doorway. When all the kids lined up, I could see that there was light evenly distributed on their faces. So, you know, again, it all comes back to that scene, seeing the light, seeing the composition, and seeing the moment. This is kind of an opposite problem. Again, it's not a great rendition of this photo, but behind them, this is like noonday Calcutta sun. And it's counterintuitive. You don't want to shoot in sun. You don't, especially overhead sun. It's terrible. So you have to take charge and pull the people out of the crappy light and put them in good light. So I had an alley behind me focusing this light, and also on overcast days. This is almost raining when I took this shot. It's on a beach. So really get your subject looking at whatever light there is, get them looking at that light, and get the light cut off on both sides and on the top, and just keep looking at the eyes. Whoa, that's a wild color. And same thing, you know, it's raining, you know, you can really see here, but there's rain on the car, and they're in a carport, but you just position myself so that there was light behind, and then let everything else go out of focus, but just nail the eyes, and if you get the eyes, and you get light. Also, zoom with your feet. This is a popular photography saying. People, I see lots of great photographers, but they're taking the same shot all the time. I like to use prime lenses, so I can't sort of zoom. I have to, you know, run forward and run backwards. So, you know, get back and get the whole scene, then go close and really mix up that. And also mixing up your perspective. This is also really important. I see a lot of people take the same shot over and over. It's a nice shot, but it's the same shot, like looking down at kids generally. Get on your stomach, climb a tree, get the kids on the ground. Again, if you just look at the light, and look and check the eyes. So same thing here. You know, this is kind of the basic recipe, although the colors are completely whack. Everything in this shot is just red or green. I had great light on the face. I had nice composition. And then the kid gave me a moment. I mean, he only gave me maybe 2 seconds of moment in an hour. But because I was ready with the other two things, and the same thing with this one. So it's coming back to the same thing off the head. It's all about seeing, and once you can see, you can anticipate. And portraiture is really all about collaboration. And so you're working with the person. So I got nice light from the ocean. I got nice out of focus foreground and background. And then the kid gave me a moment that, you know, I couldn't plan. So that's kind of some things to look for when you're making a candid portrait.